Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. This is part three of solving nonlinear systems of equations, and we're going to solve the following system on this video. So to solve this system, we could use the substitution method or the graphing method. If we were going to graph it, we would note that the first equation is linear. This happens to be a line. And the second one's a little difficult to notice right away, but if you put it in the right form, it ends up being a parabola. So that's always an option. I'm going to do this by using the substitution method. Now, in the substitution method, we take one of the variables and one of the equations and solve for the other variables. We have lots of options here. We could take the first equation and solve for y and plug it in the second equation. Or we could take the first equation and solve for x and plug it in the other equation. Or we could take the second equation. It looks like it's pretty simple to solve for y. So I see three different ways you might start this problem. And they're all good methods. I mean, good first steps. So let's see, how about if I go ahead and take the first equation and solve for y. Okay, so I'm going to take this first equation and solve for y. Because it's easy, I'll just add x to both sides. So y is x plus 4, so that means I'm going to plug x plus 4 into y in the second equation. So let's do that. So now we're going to replace y with what I have over here, my x plus 4. So I'm going to plug in x plus 4 for y. You do not have to put parentheses around it, but if it was like a 2y, you would have to remember. So that's why I did that. Minus 16. And now I have a quadratic equation because I have an x squared term. So let's see. If we add like terms on the right-hand side, 4 minus 16, that's going to be x minus 12. Okay. And then we're going to put the variables on one side, constants on the other. So I have to subtract x from both sides, and I have to add 12 to both sides. So if I subtract x, that'll be plus 7x. And add 12. And I think I'm going to be able to factor that without any trouble here. X plus 4. X plus 3 is 0. So I set each factor equal to 0. And I found two different solutions for x. Now remember, you're looking for an ordered pair of solutions for the system. So if x is negative 4, I want to back substitute back in here. And if y is x plus 4, then we could plug in negative 4 for x. So I'm going to plug in negative 4 for x, and y is 0. So together, we have that, we've got that x is negative 4, and we've got y is 0. That'll give us this ordered pair, negative 4, 0, for one of our solutions. Okay? So that's going to be one of our solutions. In fact, I think I'm going to, use solution sets here. Negative 4, 0 is one solution. All right, let's see what the other solution is going to be. We've got x equals negative 3, so we're going to plug in negative 3 into this equation. So y would be negative 3 plus 4, which is 1. So I've got when x is negative 3, y is 1. So my other solution I seem to be getting is negative 3, 1. So I'm hoping that's correct. And I never assume I get things correct, so I check my answers. So let's go ahead and check this. All right, so it looks like we have for our solutions here, these two ordered pairs. So we want to check each ordered pair in both of the equations. So first we'll check negative 4, 0. So we're going to put in, for y, we'll replace that with a 0, and we'll replace x with negative 4. And I'll say I'm going to just do it this way. And so if I simplify this side, I'm just going to get 4, and on the right side I got 4. So that one checks. Okay, let's check it in this. So in place of x, I'm putting negative 4, right? So I have negative 4 in for x. I'm just going to do the left side first. So negative 4 times negative 4 is 16, plus negative 32, that's negative 16. So the left side's negative 16. And then I'm plugging in what for y? I'm plugging in 0 for y. And that's negative 16, so that checks. So negative 4, 0 has been checked. That's the solution. Now let's do negative 3, 1. So for y, I'm putting in a 1. And for x, I'm putting in negative 3. So that gives me 1 plus 3, which is 4. And the right-hand side's 4, so it works in this first equation. And now we'll just check it in the second equation. Plugging in for x, negative 3, right here. And then for x, we're still putting in negative 3. Negative 3 times negative 3 is 9. 8 times negative 3 is negative 24. So 9 plus negative 24, I think that's negative 15. All right, now, on the right-hand side, what do we plug in for y? We're plugging in the 1. So 1 minus 16 is negative 15. So yes, it checks. So the method I used was I solved for y in this first equation, plugged it in, and I got these two solutions, and then we checked. Now, of course, we could take this same equation, and you could have graphed it. That's one method, and actually it's not too hard. And you could also do it by solving for y in the second equation and plugging it in. So there's just more than one way to do this. All right, so here's the problem again. Now, I could have solved for x in this top equation. So that would mean y, if I subtract 4 from both sides and I add x, I get that x is y minus 4. But then I would have to plug that y minus 4 in right here and in right here, right? So notice there's more arithmetic when I do that. Because you're going to have to square this. So there's going to be a lot more steps than the way I did it. But if you followed it through, you would get exactly the same answer. So I'm just going to show you. If you started out that way, I always look for what's the easiest way to do it. And I solved for y because in the other equation there was only one place where I would have to plug in y. So what happens here? I get the negative 8y and positive 8y cancel and the 16 minus 16. So I end up with y squared equals y minus 16. And again, I get a quadratic. Is that right? Oops, I made a mistake. I just saw this is supposed to be minus 32. That's another thing. More mistakes to make, the more algebra, if you have more problems like this, there's just more places to make mistakes. So let's see. I get y squared, and that's minus 16 equals y minus 16. And so I still have a quadratic, but I end up with just y squared minus y equals 0. So when I factor, I get y equals 0 or y equals 1. So you can see it takes a little bit longer to solve for y compared to when I solved it for x. Okay, but when I go back to plug it back in, right, so we're going to plug these values back in up here, what happens? When y is 0, what's x? It's y minus 4. So it's 0 minus 4, which is negative 4. And when y is 1, it says x is y minus 4, right? It's 1 minus 4, which means it was negative 3. Notice I get the same ordered pairs. I still get, look at, if x is negative 4 and y is 0, I still get negative 4, 0 for one of my solutions. And I still get negative 3, 1 for my other solution, right? Those were the two solutions that I got using the other method. So here's the way I did it the first way. Okay, and I still got negative 4, 0, and negative 3, 1. Right, I'm going to leave off doing this by graphing, but I'm going to show you just the start of it. So if I were going to do this by graphing, I would take this first equation probably and write it as y equals x plus 4, and I see that's a line. And this other one's a little bit tricky looking, but watch what happens if I just switch and I write y minus 16 equals x squared plus 8. I'm just switching what I have on the left and right side. And if I solve for y, this is a parabola, but it's not in the standard form, but this is a perfect square. So once I put it in standard form, hopefully you know the vertex is negative 4, 0, and it goes up. So if I graph this parabola, in fact, while I'm on a roll, I think I'll go ahead and do that. So let's go ahead and graph the line y equals x plus 4. This means the y-intercept is up here at 4. And slope of 1. And so I'm going to try to carefully graph that line. Here's the other ordered pair. All right, so here's a sketch of the line. All right, now how about this parabola? I've got negative 4, 0. Ah, cool. So you can see that's one of the points of intersection. There's a parabola going up over 1 and up 1. Let's see, over 2 and up 4. And if you had sketched this fairly carefully, not very good at showing that, it actually goes through the same two ordered pairs. That's negative 4, 0, and negative 3, 1. So this one isn't that difficult to graph either. But you do have to be really careful to see where it's going through. So we did do this using the substitution method two different ways, and then you can see you could also graph it. And sorry for that terrible looking parabola, but you get the idea. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.